Hello everyone, my name is Danielle and welcome to Lesson 18. Let's think back to what we did in Lesson 17. We were exploring the many ways to make 15. I asked you to have a go at helping me to make my friend a necklace. Remember, we were making a necklace for my friend, but it had to have 15. That's right. When we were together, we discovered that 10 blue and 5 yellow beads make 15. We noticed that 8 blue and 7 yellow made 15. I discovered that 9 yellow and 6 blue would make 15. Also, if I started with the 6 yellow, then added 9 blue, the total would still be 15. How did you go with your necklaces? Did you do 15? Or maybe 20? Or even 30? I can't wait to make the necklace for my friend. She will love it. In the last few lessons, we've learned some strategies for counting. We've practiced skip counting and subitizing. Today, we will practice the strategy of counting on. Our learning intention for today is to understand and use the strategy of counting on when adding or combining collections. I have a game to get us started. It's called Counters in a Cup. What's going to happen? I'm going to say a starting amount. I'm going to use my buttons to drop into the cup. You're going to count on with me. Are you ready? First, let's start at 6 and count on. Are you ready? 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Well done. Let's try another. This time, let's start at 8. Are you ready to count on? Here we go. 9, 10, 11. This time, let's start a little bit higher. This time I want you to start at 24. Let's count on. 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. Great job. Let's have a go at counting on together. This time, we're going to combine two collections. We're going to count on from the larger collection. Going to grab one handful and two. Let's remember our counting principles. We'll start with this one. Moving them away so we remember which ones have been counted. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So there are 13 in this collection. Let's count on. 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. Great job. Let's do one more. Oh, this time I'm going to start with this collection. Remember our total was 21. Let's count on. I'll take a smaller handful. So 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27. Well done. Okay, we've had a go at practicing counting on. We're going to do this in another way now. I have a game. What I need is my cup again, some counters. I'll use these buttons. I need a dice and a mat. Remember when we roll the die on the table, it makes a really loud noise. So we'll do it on a mat instead. I also need a pack of cards. I've gone through and taken out the pictures. We also need a pen and something to write on. Are you ready? We're going to pick a card. Oh, I've turned over four. We're going to place four counters in the cup. One, two, three, and one more, four. We're going to be counting on from four using our dice. I'd like to show you a special way to roll the dice so it doesn't run away from you. I call it the spider trap roll. Shake the dice in your hands and get ready to drop it. I rolled four. We're going to count on from four, four more. Are you ready? Count with me. Five, six, seven, eight. I'm wondering, how might I record this? There are different ways that you could record. You need to choose what's right for you. You might have recorded like this. Four and four is eight. Let's pick up another card. Are you ready? Oh, I've picked up seven. So we're going to place seven counters in the cup. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Let's roll and trap. I've rolled four. Let's count on four. I've got four in my hand. Now I can count on seven, eight, 9, 10, 11. 7 and 4 is 11. Some of you might be recording like this, using pictures. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 4 more is 11. One last card. I've turned over 9. Let's count out 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And let's roll. I rolled a 3. So we're going to count on 3 more. Here's my 3, starting at 9, 10, 11, 12. Now some of you might be recording like this. 9 add 3 is 12. Have you used or seen this before? 9 add 3 equals 12. That might be a way you could try. If you're feeling like a challenge and would like to count on from a larger amount, you might like to choose a numeral from your hundreds chart. You might have made one with Claire. This time, on a little bit of paper, I want you to choose a numeral. I'm going to start from 66. Write it down on the paper. 6, 6. That's your starting point. 66. Roll. Trap. You're going to count on 2. Let's get 2 counters ready for our cup. 66. 67. 68. Let's go back and check. Starting at 66, counting on 2, 67, 68. It works. Find a way of recording that works for you. Thanks for working so hard with me today. Remember, in today's lesson, we have practiced counting on. We've discovered it's a faster and more efficient way of counting. Your home task is to practice counting on using things you might have at home, like buttons or leaves or even gum nuts. Remember to record the way that works for you. We've tried a few different options today. Another way you could practice counting on at home is by playing one of the cup games we tried today. Have fun, and I'll see you next time.